Getting a job to get started in a career is important to one and all. Traditionally, the job search process required a lot of steps, right from searching an organization, preparing a resume and writing letters of applications, and running around through employment agencies and consultants. In the present context of changing tech world, this job search process is enormously changed. While resume writing is an intellectual design process of personifying one as an employable candidate, job interview process is the ultimate test of an individual's employability. So in this session, I'm going to discuss about how important it is to write resume and what are the factors to be considered, and also to discuss how to draft a cover letter with an example. Hence, resume writing is not an easy and a simple task. It requires a lot of creativity and smartness. So let's get into the introductory aspect. For most job seekers, a good resume is what stands out between a dream job and a choice job. A strong resume communicates your qualifications and set you up for career success. A resume is a document, a formal document, that provides an overview of your qualifications, including your relevant past work experiences, skills, educational background, and noteworthy accomplishments, awards or rewards that you have received in the past. Usually, it is paired with a cover letter. A resume helps you demonstrate your abilities and convince employers you are a qualified, talented, and a smart individual, and hence you are hireable. Let's know some background aspects of the word resume. The word resume actually originates from French, and which means summary. To this day, the purpose of a resume is still to provide employers with a summary of your relevant accomplishments and qualifications. If you are applying for a job, you need at least a resume to be considered for the position. So employment-related correspondence includes applications, resume, and job acceptance or decline from applicant side, and interview, appointment, confirmation from your employer side. Therefore, it is desirable that these transactions take place efficiently and with courtesy. Resume is a summary of pertinent facts about a candidate. It is a formal arrangement of personal inventory of skills and knowledge, and it has to be updated from time to time. So it contains a summary of relevant and key job information of the past experience and education. Now, why do we need it, the purpose? Resume can be used for a variety of reasons, but most often they are used to secure new employment. It may serve several purposes for individuals as well as for organization. Let us discuss the purpose of a resume to an individual. Firstly, it helps to make a self-analysis. A resume compels you to think about yourself, your goals, your achievements, and your shortfalls. It helps you to clarify your directions, qualifications, and strength. It boosts your confidence or to start the process of committing to a job or career change. It is an important aid for career building. So that is a benefit of a resume for self-analysis. How does it become a selling tool? It is often serving for the purpose is to win an interview. It is a self-advertisement where one candidate puts across to the recruiting agent or an employer about what is he worth all about. Therefore, once I read through your resume, I do understand what is the candidate's potential and his accomplishments in the past. So it motivates this employer to think about selecting the candidate. And definitely it helps you to get an eye of the reader and help them to call you for an interview. So it is the message which you communicate effectively to the employer about all your credentials. So these are the benefits of a resume for an individual. How does it benefit an organization? An organization gets the benefit of screening the candidates. Recruiters have a tough task of choosing the right candidate from a large pile of applications. So the resume helps the employer to find out the right candidate before carrying out the selection process. So it saves the time and effort by projecting skills required for the job. So it is definitely beneficial to the organizations. How does it help the organizations for records and recommendations? A resume we put in an employer's personal files. When need arises, the employer may call the best candidate by reading their CV or bio data or a resume, and they may recommend to call the candidate as and when there is a need in the organization. So therefore, resume is beneficial to both the individuals and organization. Let's move on. The most important letter is the cover letter. Along with your resume, you have to submit a cover letter. So what is a cover letter? Employers have several preferences on receiving resume and job applications. If the applicants know the company, they can personally call and inquire their preferred way of receiving their resume. If the job opening was posted in newspaper advertisement, you can also read and understand the directions given. So when sending out your CV or bio data or resume, you should accompany their resume with cover letter. So you can also send a soft copy if you're mailing it to them, or you have to take care about the format in which you're going to send. So let's discuss about the cover letter. It is an opportunity to demonstrate more of your personality than what you can cover in your resume. Throughout the letter, you can discuss specific items listed in the job descriptions and how your skills and experience can match those requirements. And remember, cover letters are not compulsory. They are often optional. So sending one with your resume can show your eagerness to get the job. Including a cover letter when a company doesn't require one lets your future employer know that you aim to exceed their expectations, which could make you a more desirable candidate. An exception to this is if the application specifically notes to do include a cover letter, in which case you should follow the employer's directions. So cover letters are of two types, solicited and unsolicited. Solicited, application in response to an advertisement. Unsolicited, cold calls on own initiative of the candidate. A good application aims at winning an interview from the employer. So when you're sending your cover letter, remember to add the inside address, salutation, that is dear sir, your personal information, and start with an opening paragraph. Move on with the middle paragraph, that is the body of your entire content, and do have a concluding paragraph. And never forget to close it with the right words, that is complimentary close and signature. Use Miss or Mr. or Mrs. and enclosures should also be stated and specified. Let us look at the most important tips which can help you to make and draft a better cover letter. Always keep it short and crisp. In a few sentences, explain why you are a great fit for the specific role. State why you are excited about the job and the company and how the job matches your career goals. In one or two paragraphs, connect your past accomplishments with the requirements listed in the job description. Focus on your most relevant experience, qualifications, and skills. When possible, quantify your accomplishments with facts and data. Avoid repeating the bullet points from your resume. Close by thanking the employer for their time and consideration. You may also want to sum up your qualifications for the role and express an interest in continuing to the next stage in the hiring process. So we have taken an example for the one who's applying for the teaching job. So he keeps his cover letter as simple and short. So he addresses to the principal and specifies that I have been passionate about teaching since I began with tutoring for supporting my family in high school. I have 7 years of teaching experience. instructing children with a diverse range of abilities. I'm also successful at boosting achievements, having increased average grades by 15% at my current school. I believe this makes me an ideal candidate for the role. So he's highlighting about his achievements. And when you see the percentage, it's 15%, definitely you can trust. And he's also leaving his contact number, mail ID, and submits it. So this is a sample of a cover letter. So thank you. Hope this session has helped you in learning the introductory aspect of resume writing.